Hello and welcome to TradingFloor.com's weekly Asian Focus. In this report with Andrew Robinson, FX analyst for Saxo Capital Markets in Singapore, he takes a look at how peripheral Asian central banks are positioned for handling the global economic slowdown. And in particular, he looks at the central banks of India, Korea and Indonesia. Welcome, Andrew.
Hello again.
With the People's Bank of China having demonstrated its rising concerns by cutting both its reserve ratio requirement and deposit rates this year, how do these other central banks compare in their willingness, need and room to tamper with monetary policy?
I think one of the major facts about the Asian central banks is that they do have, or appear to have, a lot more ammunition in their toolbox than the Western central banks. Interest rates are nowhere near zero. A biggest problem that Asia faced over the back end of last year was inflation. That seems to be dissipating at the moment, so it's basically clearing the way for further interest rate easings. So in those two respects, I think the ability is there. When it comes to the need, I think definitely there are warning signals. We're already seeing that China growth is at a three-year low. South Korean growth is at a close to a two-year low. And so they're all ready and able to act. It's just a question of when and how much. We've already seen the Bank of Korea. They did surprise the markets last week with a 25 basis rate cut, and they did emphasize that it was due to the global economic slowdown, and it was more of an insurance buy rather than an actual physical need to do something. So I think that's setting the tone for most of the Asian central banks across this region.
There's also talk that the People's Bank of China will act again very soon, considering the slew of poor economic data recently. Will this spur the other central banks in Asia to also act faster and perhaps sooner?
I think, yes, obviously China is a major kingpin for the Asian economies, but I don't think that necessarily any move by China will automatically produce a move by the Asian central banks. One thing I forgot to mention in the earlier point was that India is perhaps a special case. Whilst the rest of Asia is enjoying slower inflation, India is actually finding inflation pretty steady, and it's pretty steady at high levels. At the moment, we're just above 7% on an inflation annual basis, but this is down from a peak of 9.2, but it's still very, very high. And that is one of the reasons why in June, the Reserve Bank of India didn't cut rates. They said that there was actually no benefit to either the economy or the inflation outlook by reducing rates. So they are a central bank on their own, which is struggling with the age-old theme of high inflation. So I think the Reserve Bank of India will probably be on hold and wait to cut rates until inflation starts to behave. If we look at Indonesia, then they've never really struggled during the economic downturn over the past 3 years. Inflation has been steady, and it's indicative that the Bank Indonesia is perhaps going to stay on hold for the rest of the year, maybe introduce a small cut in the third quarter, but generally they are on hold. So we can see a different spectrum across the different central banks. So I think it's not necessarily going to be spurred by a China move. It's all going to be very much dependent on what's happening within the individual economies.
And further afield, Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke's testimony to Congress, in that he indicated that the Fed stands ready to introduce more quantitative easing measures. Did these words perhaps change anything from an Asian central bank perspective?
I don't think so, basically. Mr. Bernanke was pretty nondescript about his ideas about when the next phase of QE will come in. And so it's very much wait and see for things to possibly deteriorate. So I think in that respect, there are no clues from him for the Asian central banks, and they will very much make the moves on their own back just as and when they feel necessary.
Thanks for your insight into the Asian region this week, Andrew.
You're welcome.
Take a look at TradingFloor.com to see more of what Andrew and his colleagues are writing about.